How long, O Lord, will I call for help,
and you will not hear?
The wicked hem in the righteous.
Therefore, justice,
is perverted.
This biblical proverb gives name to a group of volunteers calling themselves pervertedjustice.com. They claim the wicked are the men who might try to contact your kids on the internet.
I'm 14, by the way.
You have an angel smile.
We've recreated an actual online chat between a 35-year-old Bay Area man.
I know I'm too old for you, but I have to take a chance on an angel.
And what appears to be 14-year-old Sarah girl from Lakeland.
You're not that old, and you're really sweet.
Like many online conversations between an adult and a child, this quickly turns to one subject.
I just met you. I don't want to scare you by talking about sex.
Sarah Girl's really a grown man connected with pervertedjustice.com. The group of internet vigilantes are based in Portland, Oregon.
The good we're doing is that we're making it even more dangerous to go online in a regional room and try to hook up with an underage kid.
A man who calls himself Xavier Von Erk started the website 2 years ago.
I think basically what we're doing is we're making it safer for the kids who don't have parents that can keep them out of internet chat rooms.
During the chat, Perverted Justice volunteers convince men to send their pictures and their phone numbers. Most do. So Perverted Justice posts the photos, phone numbers, and transcripts of the X-rated chats on their website for thousands to see.
Mostly our goal is exposure, exposing the people to the people they know about what they've done online.
You know, I guess I was acting stupidly.
This Bay Area man we'll call Andrew was the one chatting with Sarah Girl. We're concealing Andrew's identity because he has not committed a crime.
You know, it was one thing led to another, and then we were to hook up the next night. There's one thing to actually go through with something, and there's another thing just to BS online.
Andrew is one of more than 550 men posted on pervertedjustice.com. Others include a Washington, D.C. cop, a police dispatcher in a Boston suburb, a Michigan high school teacher, and a registered sex offender in Colorado, all caught chatting sex with vigilantes posing as kids.
But to them, no, it's different. I am a wannabe pedophile.
Andrew says he never really believed he was talking to a child. But after his phone number and chat with Sarah Girl was posted online, Andrew's home was flooded with phone calls.
The first 4 days, there were a lot. There was probably received maybe 40 or 50 phone calls, and anywhere from 10, 15 death threats.
He had a very terrible conversation. He admitted to the terrible conversation himself in a right of reply, and people called him and told him he had a terrible conversation. That's why you don't have those kinds of conversations online.
Xavier Von Erk says his goal is not to get people in trouble, just to deter them from searching for sex on the web with kids and embarrassing them if they try. Dave Bowman, Tampa-based 10 News.